Hello, dear students. Today, our topic is S3 heart sound, or also known as ventricle gallop. In this video, we will understand what exactly is S3, what is the mechanism of S3, what are the causes of S3, where to auscultate for S3, and how to auscultate for S3 heart sound. So let's start with S3 sound. So S3 sound is also known as ventricle gallop. So this is also known as ventricle gallop. What exactly is the mechanism for this sound? So the mechanism for this sound is the keywords. It is because of increase in ventricle blood. So increase ventricle blood, and this increase ventricle blood is during the passive filling phase of ventricles. Passive filling phase. So what will happen? That ventricle will contain more blood during this phase, and it will vibrate due to increased blood volume, and that vibration is known as S3 sound. So what exactly causes this increased ventricle blood during the passive filling phase? For that, you need to understand the cardiac cycle first. So look at these diagrams of the cardiac cycle. For example, I am starting with the end systole. So this is a end systole, say this is the aorta. I am taking the left ventricle just for convenience point of view. This is the left ventricle. Now, when left ventricle has ejected whole of its blood, still there is some blood which will be left in the ventricle cavity. And that blood which is left in the ventricle cavity even after the end systole is known as end systolic volume. End systolic volume. This is at end of systole. End of systole. This is physiological. Why? Because the ejection fraction, suppose, is 70%. So just for round figures, ki if 100 ml blood was there in the ventricle cavity, ejection fraction was 70%, means 70 ml blood will go and 30 ml blood remain in the ventricle cavity, and that is known as end systolic volume. Now, what will happen subsequently? Subsequently, the AV valve will open, and this is the mitral valve on the left side. This is the left atria, and already the blood was present before, and that blood was end systolic volume. And in this example, we have taken it as 30 ml of end systolic volume. While in the passive filling phase, the blood from the atria will also come into the ventricle, and it will fill the ventricle with that blood. That blood, we will call this as atrial blood. This is a atrial blood during the passive filling phase. So this blood is suppose 50 ml. So what is the total quantity here? Now the total quantity of blood will be 80 ml, just for remembering. So when will this blood volume? This is the blood volume during the passive filling phase. When will this increase? So the cause for this increase will be, as you can understand from this diagram, the cause can be two, the mechanism can be two. Either it will be the cause here will be of S3, that means increased ventricle blood volume. Cause number one, it could be increase end systolic volume. This end systolic volume is increased. And when will this end systolic volume will increase? When the ejection fraction of the ventricle is reduced. The blood ejected is less, so the blood which is retained will be more. So end systolic volume that occur due to द सिस्टोलिक डिसफंक्शन ऑफ द वेंट्रिकल्स. सिस्टोलिक डिसफंक्शन. एंड सब ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स फॉर द सिस्टोलिक डिसफंक्शन विल इंक्लूड द पॉपुलर टर्म्स विच वी यूज. दीज आर लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल फेलियर, इट विल प्रोड्यूस अ लेफ्ट साइड S3. राइट वेंट्रिकल फेलियर, इट विल प्रोड्यूस अ राइट साइडेड S3. इट कैन बी बिकॉज ऑफ डायलेटेड कार्डियोमायोपैथी, बिकॉज डायलेटेड कार्डियोमायोपैथी इज करेक्टराइज बाय अ डिक्रीज इन द सिस्टोलिक फंक्शन. इट कैन ऑल्सो बी बिकॉज ऑफ द वेंट्रिकल एन्यूरिज्म्स. तो वेंट्रिकल एन्यूरिज्म्स मीन्स कि दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द वेंट्रिकल विच इज नॉट कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग एंड इट बल्ज आउट इन सिस्टोल. सो एनी पार्ट ऑफ द वेंट्रिकल विच इज नॉट कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग विल कॉज अ सिस्टोलिक डिसफंक्शन एज वेल एज एक्यूट MI बिकॉज कॉन्ट्रैक्शंस विल बी रिड्यूस्ड. नाउ द कॉज नंबर टू, अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस मैकेनिज्म, इट कुड बी बिकॉज ऑफ द एट्रियल ब्लड. एट्रियल ब्लड इज मोर एंड द रीजन्स फॉर इंक्रीज एट्रियल ब्लड. सो द सेकेंड मैकेनिज्म और सेकेंड कॉज हेयर विल बी इंक्रीज इन एट्रियल ब्लड. सो वाई दिस इंक्रीज इन द एट्रियल ब्लड विल बी ड्यू टू. सो दिस विल बी ड्यू टू द फैक्ट दैट इफ देर इज अ हाई कार्डियक आउटपुट. So in the high cardiac output, blood ejection is more, the blood volume is more, that blood will return back into the atria again, the atrial filling will be increased. So increase atrial blood is due to increase atrial blood filling due to any reason, blood filling. And one of the predominant reason is a high cardiac output conditions. So the high cardiac output means ki there is a more blood everywhere in the cardiovascular system including in the ventricles, and that will be during the passive filling phase. So the causes of the high cardiac output, these can be physiological cause, means pregnancy, or it could be a pathological cause which include cardiovascular causes like aortic regurgitation, mitral regurgitation and patent ductus arteriosus. Non-cardiovascular cause of high cardiac output conditions that include hyperthyroidism. So these causes are discussed in the other video, ki what are the causes of high cardiac output with their mechanisms like hyperthyroidism, it could be a severe anemia, it could be beriberi, Paget's disease or AV fistulas. All of them can cause the high cardiac output conditions. There are other miscellaneous conditions where the atrial blood filling can be increased. That is dependent on ki which side heart pathology is present. So the other causes in this group can be, the first cause is a high cardiac output state. The other cause can be, you can look from this diagram, this is left atria, this is right atria. So what will happen, and these are the ventricle, right ventricle, left ventricle. So this is a normal blood which is coming into the right atria, and if there is a atrial septal defect, so extra blood will come from the left atria into the right atria. So as a result, during the diastole, the more blood will go to the right side. So that means atrial septal defect, ASD, and it will cause the right ventricle S3, right sided S3 will be produced here. The other cause of the miscellaneous cause of the S3 will be left atrial filling is increased, and the cause of the left atrial blood filling is increased, it include the ventricle septal defect. So in the ventricle septal defect, what happens? So this is a very paradox looking statement, that VSD is the left ventricle blood is going into right ventricle. but it is going in the systole, and the right ventricle blood, normal blood is also ejected through pulmonary valve, and the extra blood is also ejected through the pulmonary valve, but that is happening in the systolic phase. In the systolic phase, so what will happen, more blood will reach the left atria, and left atria, this mitral valve is closed in systole, MV closed in systole. So as a result, the more filling of the left atria occur in the systole, and in the diastole, increased blood will go into the left ventricle in passive filling. So the VSD will cause a left ventricle S3, because that blood is going during the systolic phase, and in the systolic phase, right ventricle cavity is open cavity. So immediately blood will leave the right ventricle cavity and it will fill the left atria because the valve is closed of left atria. Now, where to look for these sounds? So that means ki where should we put the stethoscope? So the site will be right ventricle S3, and best way to remember is it is heard at the right ventricle area. And where is the right ventricle area? This is also known as the tricuspid area. It is at the left lower parasternum. While the left ventricle S3, it is heard at the left ventricle area, and left ventricle area is the mitral area, that is also known as the apex. That means left fifth intercostal space, just medial to mid clavicular line, Now, how should we put the stethoscope? So that means ki the pitch, whether we use the bell of the stethoscope or diaphragm. So we will use the bell because it is a low pitch sound characteristically. This S3 is a very, very important heart sound for practicals as well as for the MCQs also. So if a question come to you whether S3 is physiological, answer is S3 can be physiological also. It is physiological in pregnancy as well as it can be physiological in young children, because blood volume is more relatively than the ventricle size. So ventricle will vibrate in those conditions. So these were the basic concepts of S3, and if there is any questions or any doubt, you can ask under the comment section. Thank you.